Jeez, that's really loud. Sorry, guys. Alright, guys. Thank you so much for joining the stream. My name is Brandy, also known as Loving Your Style. I stream over here on twitch.tv/lovingyourstyle. Thank you guys for joining. Come with me while I play some Super Seducer. Talking about a game? We're gonna go in here and it's so loud. Sorry, I'm turning the volume down on that. And Amy, thank you for your host. Alright, guys. So loud, wait. So loud. Rocky Hardcore, how are you? Go into story mode. We're gonna go to chapter 4, sitting, girls sitting in a coffee shop. How are you, the Rocky Core? What's up? Welcome to the stream. Finally over the hangover. How are you? Wow, you had a hangover that long? That sucks. Welcome to the stream. We're gonna play some Super Seducer, so if anyone wants to join in on chat, you're more than welcome to answer some of the questions here. I'm gonna go ahead out of Discord just because I'll be distracted. one for St. Patrick's Day and one for your brother's birthday. Nice. Alright, in the local coffee shop is a pretty blonde lady. She is sitting and reading. Can you make yourself more interesting than the book and get her number? Alright, so we gotta try and get this chick's number, so see how that's gonna go. Ooh. Right off the bat, let me just go ahead and post that I'm live here. My luck, I would have thrown the coffee in her face. Oh my gosh. Okay, so A, find out about her. B is use books as a wall to show off. C, show her hair is kind of, say her hair is kind of nice and transition to inviting her back to your house. Obviously not C. C is like way overboard, and C is like, oh man, I need to turn my music off. C is like way overboard, and it's like overdoing the. It's like too much. D is ask her when she comes. Ask her whether she comes here often. Yeah, D is a good one. Just like general talk.
Come here often to this coffee shop?
No, not really.
No, first time maybe, second
I've
time.
been here a few times, but
That's cool.
yeah.
You go to other coffee shops usually, or just not much coffee drinking going on, or you take it away maybe.
I do all of those things.
All of
Ooh,
them.
she's
That's
like
cool. Variety.
really.
Yeah.
They say variety is the spice of life.
They do.
So it's good that you don't come here often and do the same thing and sit in the same chair, right?
Yeah, I think so.
That's good.
I don't
We always
know.
want to
She
stay away
seems
from the
really.
standard questions and standard answers, and this one is just an example of the usual lame stuff that guys come up with, so don't do it.
Oh.
So, how are you able to be free in the middle of the morning on a Thursday?
Well, I do have a job, but it's just kind of from the laptop, from home, or from anywhere. But it's like internet stuff, and
He
we're from America,
goes
so
angrily,
in
smashes the
Europe,
table,
I need to wait
and throws
until
things on the
10 o'clock
ground.
in whatever time
Crassy
I'm free,
fingers.
and then can be working at home, lying in bed, lying on the balcony, generally lying down, working. So
That's nice.
that's cool. And how about you? How come you're not at work
Well,
now?
I work at the university, so I have kind of an unusual schedule. I have some free time during the day, and I work in the evenings.
Nice.
Yeah.
Guess that teaches sex ed. Wow. Hella no, you're not gonna say A. Say you didn't go to university and knew it was a waste of time. Or C, find out whether she loves her job and if she's just doing it for the money. I guess I would pick C, because obviously these two answers are pretty bad. Guess that she teaches sex ed would be ridiculous. Tell her you didn't go to university, it was a waste of time, would be kind of rude.
You teach at the university. That's interesting.
Yeah.
And tell me, do you actually like what you do, or you do it just for money?
No, I really do like what I do.
Great. You feel like you're making a difference in people's lives and all of this?
Yeah, I actually do. I honestly, I feel like what I do is important and that the information I convey will be valuable to these people and to my students.
That could be true because I still remember my teachers from primary school and. In secondary school, I don't know if you're the same, but did you like the subjects most where the teachers were good? And then later, maybe you weren't even interested in that subject. So a good teacher can just change the whole course of someone's life.
Absolutely. And like looking back and thinking, what years of school are your favorite? It's like, well, whatever year you had the good teachers, because what you learn is kind of irrelevant.
And you're a good teacher? They
I
like
think
you?
so. I hope so.
That's cool.
Try.
No, I like it, to be honest, because it's very rare. You know, most people just do their job for money and then they come and moan about it and they hate it. So it's good to meet someone like you who actually enjoys what they do and is making a difference.
This is a nice thing that you can ask anyone. So well done for picking this. It's the right option. And it can always lead to an interesting conversation. Whether she's into her job, she can tell you why, or she's not, and she can tell you something else that she's passionate about.
Learning how to get a wife.
And
Yes,
what's the
July,
subject
let's
that you teach?
go.
American culture.
Huh, what does that entail?
So kind of a lot, quite a few different themes. For example, we kind of started with an overview of American values, which was really interesting.
Like freedom and stuff, yeah?
Things like that, and even more so, for example, an interesting one is how Americans relate to the future. Like it's something we feel like we can
Hey, Mal
control
Mal
in some
51,
sense,
welcome to
and
the
like
stream.
back to
Wait,
the
these
future,
aren't girls.
the movie.
This is a girl.
I don't know what you mean.
Okay, but Americans think that they control their own destiny,
Yeah.
kind of, yeah?
Ask what exactly you suggest about inventing donuts and burgers. B, challenge her to explain why this is important. Or C, make her feel good about her job. C.
In American culture, what's that? It's like George Steinbeck, Edgar Allan
Sure, that's part of it. Yeah, I think my focus is more on what we could call contemporary culture.
Britney Spears.
Sure.
Kanye.
Sure, that is all relevant. Yeah.
Oh, wow. So it must be really interesting for the students. They're not learning about things thousands of years ago.
Yeah, I think so. And just kind of seeing how the Kanyes and the Kardashians, how their influence reverberates through American society and how that affects how Americans think.
Mm. And why is it useful for the students?
Because a lot of these students aren't going to stay in their home country, and at some point they'll be interacting.
Viva Wednesday! Thank you so much for your host.
Interacting with Americans, and to have some perspective on their psychology or their ideology, whatever it is.
Hey, Gio.
Right? Because American culture is pervasive. You know, it's kind of everywhere. Seems to lead the world. I know that in England...
Playing a great game called Super Seducer. Thank you for joining.
It all follows, and then Europe a little bit later.
Mm-hmm.
No, it's pretty cool. And more than that, it must be really interesting for the kids.
Yeah, I think so.
Mm-hmm.
When someone has something that they actually care about in their life, you don't want to tease them about it or denigrate it. So it's good to give them some validation on something like this, you know, the job that she's obviously passionate about.
I really enjoy my job, but there is this one little thing that's very frustrating for me. I've got this problem where
I can't
print all the copies that I need.
Oh.
But I want my students to all have their own copy to take home, but then I have to go to the printer every day, and it gets kind of expensive. What do you think I should do?
Oh my god, he was looking at that other girl. He wasn't paying attention. Say it. It must be annoying to tell her to ask her for a bigger printing allowance. B, tell her if she has a colleague she doesn't like, she can ignore them. C, be general and vague because you didn't listen. D, be honest and say you were distracted by the girl. So it must be annoying to tell her to ask for a bigger printing allowance. Really wasn't paying attention.
Well, that's bad. So I guess you don't have enough papers for students and stuff. Yeah,
that's part of it.
Mm. I guess you can ask for more allowance or get them to share. But yeah, it's annoying.
Mm-hmm.
Well done. You weren't distracted by the sexy chick that walked by, and that's something that you can use out there. Well done for paying attention and getting the right response.
Teaching thing.
Tell her you were distracted.
Important in your life. What else do you have to do?
I really love dogs, and I love to travel.
Travel?
Yeah.
Ooh.
Cool. Do you travel a lot?
I've traveled quite a bit these last couple of years, especially.
Nice. And where are some places you've been?
He's looking at that booty, though.
Dog,
looking for
Russia,
that booty.
Ukraine.
That juicy booty.
Latvia.
Wow.
So all of Eastern Europe and kind of former USSR. Nice. And tell me, what's the absolute best place you've seen? Like, if people who have never traveled anywhere say, where's the best place I should go?
I would actually say that you should go to the United States and go see the Grand Canyon. It's amazing. I can't do it justice with words.
I've lived so far about getting a wife, and I share with other girls, but while the future wife, because other girls could be real future wife, noted. What is this? Hey, Killer Taken. It's a game called Super Seducer. Thank you for joining the stream. A, tell her about your experiences in Grand Canyon. Just one second, guys. Sorry, I have a phone call. It's a very interesting game. Very interesting game. All right, tell her about your experiences in the Grand Canyon. Say it's boring and don't have to go. Don't even have Wi-Fi. B, say you've never been, but you like to go. B is a good one. Tell her to elaborate on what she particularly liked about it. Tell her your future trip going to Thailand and details of sexual experiences you had there. Obviously, you wouldn't say E because it's cray-cray. I would say B, say that you would like to go there.
Grand Canyon, yeah, I've never been there, but I'd like to go. Maybe, you know, go to, what's a good trip? Go to New York, go to LA, San Francisco, Vegas, and then it's somewhere near there, isn't it?
So it's over there, yeah.
Yeah, somewhere.
Hey!
Somewhere in that region.
Mm-hmm. Antrax, welcome back to the stream.
Just hang out for what? What's good, like 2 days? Or
I think
just
2 days.
Day trip?
You could do it in a day, or 2 days would be better, but one day you could do that, yeah.
I always wanted to go since I saw Superman 2, when they go down on the, he goes down on the donkey because he's too scared to go on the flying things, and then Superman comes and they have their base in the Grand Canyon. So it was, when I was a kid, it was good. I always wanted to go. You should watch it, Superman. Classic.
Oh, okay. If it's got the Grand Canyon in it.
Mm-hmm. This is coming back to
this
you.
This is actually,
you know,
pretty good.
Everything to yourself is not the best answer.
Ooh,
and it's not
necessary.
It's
not the best answer.
Keep the conversation focused on her at this point.
Oh, should I say that? No. Oh. I've run out of things to say.
Oh my god. You ran out of things to say. A, hold eye contact and wait for her to speak. B, break eye contact and see around the venue while you think what to say. C, say you hate awkward silence. Oh my goodness. What the fuck are you playing? Hi, Zoner. I'm playing a game called Super Seducer. Thank you for joining. So should we hold eye contact and wait for her to speak? Or she looks so like upset that, okay, I need to move my face. This is what she looks like though. She's like, she looks mad. Look at her face. She's like, why are you doing this to me? Will you guys guess? Guess in chat. Eye contact and wait for her to speak. I kind of want to do this one, but I don't want to say, like, so you hate awkward silences would be like okay too. See,
you know, I hate awkward silences, but the good thing is that's only because we don't know each other too well, so we won't have any when we're great friends, right?
Yeah, hopefully.
That's a good one.
This is not an absolute rule, but in most cases it's correct, so well done.
Good job, Zoner. You know how to get a grill.
As long as I can remember, I've always loved playing volleyball, so that's something
okay.
I try to do whenever I can.
Nice. I played it at school. They had it in my school, but since then I didn't. But they play, I go to Barcelona a lot and they play on the beach.
Mm-hmm.
Do you play beach volleyball?
I will, yeah.
Oh, very
in a
nice.
Pinch.
Are you very good?
Yeah.
You can do that where you jump and smash
sure.
it down.
Cool. Oh yeah, Kriyasm.
Because the nets are higher.
Ninja, why the fuck are these girls in bras?
Yeah,
it's the name of the game. Super Seducer.
For hobbies.
Alright, tell her you're stupid and that. Tell her it's stupid. No. Obviously, compliment her on choosing a tough language to learn. T, tell her she failed miserably with languages at school. Tell her you failed miserably. D, show off telling her, no, we're going to do B, compliment her.
Russian?
Yeah.
You know, I meet loads of people that speak, what, French, English, obviously, Spanish, German.
Choose the wrong answers.
Russian,
no.
Yeah. Cool. How come you chose that?
I don't really have a good reason. When I was in high school, I had the opportunity to do a study abroad, and my choices were France and Russia, and I didn't want to go to France, so I went to Russia, and then I just never quit.
Mm-hmm. I actually like that you chose something tough,
mm-hmm.
and that you stuck with it,
mm-hmm.
and, you know, like I said, most people take the easy options all the time, so it's interesting and cool that you did that.
She likes it.
Nice one. You know, when a girl has something that is a real talent, something that she should be proud of, something she's worked hard on, that's the kind of thing you don't want to tease her too much. So, you know, say well done, say you respect that, and say why. And then go deeper into it, because, you know, you need to find out why she would do that, why she was interested, what would make her spend the time on it. And it's going to lead to interesting conversation, make her feel good as well.
I noticed you have an accent. Do you mind if I ask where you're from?
England, actually.
Whereabouts?
Born in London, but actually, you know what? When I was young, I lived in South London, and they have a strong accent there. It's like South London and things like this. But because I travelled a lot and I moved, I've lost most of my accent. But do I still sound British to you?
Yes, very much.
That's good.
All right. You like British accent, don't you? And you like my British accent, don't you, B? Tell her how girls go crazy about the British accent and tell her you get laid everywhere. C, talk about how foreigners perceive English people and ask how people react to her as an American. I guess C would be good because you're more elaborate and you want to get to know her more. So C is probably the best answer because you want to get to know her more. This is just, like, so ridiculous. Who would say, like, B? Like, that's ridiculous. A, you like my British accent, don't you? No.
Do you like the English accent?
Yeah.
Yeah, most people like it. They say it's sexy. But maybe that's just when I speak it. It's quite interesting actually being English because in some places,
this is a girl's
like
perspective.
America,
had a good girl.
A good reputation.
This is not a boy's perspective.
Spain, English people go and kind of party and like the hooligans go drinking and stuff. So their reputation's bad.
Yes.
How do you find it being an
American? I know best.
Depends on where you're at, but I guess generally people have kind of negative stereotypes about the United States and Americans.
You want to know more about her, so you're going to ask questions regarding like her background
and judge you individually and not.
That's good, right?
That's how you get a grill. That's how you get a grill, Zoner.
Racism or anything really bad against us almost anywhere we go, right?
Yeah, that's true.
Mm-hmm.
This is the right choice, and it's always interesting to talk about cultural differences, so it can lead to some nice conversations.
Sport now. No, he said this is the right choice. A is say you like her and want to see her again and ask for her number. B is say you think she's incredibly beautiful and that you want to take her on a date. C, ask her what she likes to do in her free time. I think I should just do A because we've been talking for a long time already. I could go into, like, depth about what she likes to do in her free time, but we've literally been talking, like, a lot already. B. Say she's incredibly beautiful and you want to take her on a date. Okay. What do you guys think in chat? I never choose B, Ninja. You never call a girl incredibly beautiful? I mean, it's a pickup line, but some people do like to be called beautiful sometimes. I would say either A or B. Jav, welcome to the stream. You think A? Yeah, I think you should just go in for the kill, right?
Well, listen, it's been wonderful speaking with you. So maybe I could get your number and we hang out sometime.
I'm sorry. It really was nice talking to you, but I just I don't think so.
Why, you don't like men, or you have a boyfriend?
I just don't want to see you again.
Okay, but it wasn't nice, right? Nice,
yeah, it was alright.
Yeah, I liked it too. Yeah, well, I wasn't going to see you again as well. I just said it to be polite. But
okay.
That's alright, don't worry about that. Cool, see you then, and enjoy your book.
Thank you.
Coffee and, yeah.
This is a case of going for the number when you're not sure that she likes you. If you are having an open conversation, if you find things that you could do together, if she's smiling, then you can ask for the number. If you ask for it otherwise,
oh my God.
Even if you're persistent, it's likely to fail.
She was like, nope. B-Max, welcome to the stream. Thank you for joining. Look into my eyes. Goodness, B-Max. Tell me what you see, what you can see. The smile that I'm putting on the front, that I'm putting on for you. I spill my soul in the microphone with poems written in blood, hopes that it's enough for you. Welcome to the stream, B-Max. Should pick C. Love and B. Literally listen to me. No, I don't think it's going to be B, Zoner. B is coming on way too strong. She was already so mad when you said, okay, well, whatever. I'll pick
well,
B.
Listen, I hope you don't find it forward of me, but I just think you're stunning, and I want to take you on a very romantic date. Dinner, candles, the whole
She week. Seems like she's not going to like
really
that.
That's really sweet, but unfortunately, I actually am kind of seeing someone.
Is it very serious? You're going to get married?
It's pretty serious.
Maybe room for a little, you know?
Hey, Mr. Jet Setter, what's up?
No, I don't think so. I'm pretty serious about him.
Oh my god.
Should nothing gain, as they say. It's great to meet you, and I'll go and cry. No, I mean, I'll go. No, it's okay. All right, see ya.
Bye.
It's too early to make that kind of move. That's why that didn't work.
Oh my god. See.
What do you like to do in, I don't know, for fun, like in the evening? Because you study Russian and whatever.
Sitting with it,
you
if you're serious with him.
Anything else?
All of the above, yeah.
Yeah?
Mm-hmm.
At the same
time? Hey, Madsen.
When the mood strikes.
You're right.
Cool. Yeah,
you're right, Dragon.
Cocktail bars, different bars. Do you smoke shisha?
Hookah.
Yeah, hookah, you call it in America.
Ninja.
Yeah, from time to time.
Told you to give her the D, right?
I quite like it.
That's Ninja.
Seems unhealthy.
That's a horrible answer.
But
I told you to give her the D. Really?
It's healthy?
Yeah. So we need to do it sometime. Like shisha, hookah, cocktails, and then dancing.
Oh, maybe.
She said
when
maybe.
You want to transition to seeing someone again, it's very good to.
Madsen, job on Twitch.
Kind of
everybody thinks that's right.
They spend their time because you might find a mutual connection. You find that you share some activities or that you do some things that she wants to do, she does some things that you'd like to try, and then it makes it very easy to then go on and suggest the date from there and take the number.
And do you have any other outdoor, like, active stuff you like to do?
Yeah.
Like volleyball, but anything else?
Yeah, I grew up in the country, so I really enjoy a lot of nature activities.
Well, the next woman, don't waste your time on this chick. Off on this guy's right, B-Max?
Yeah.
Wow.
Isn't that funny?
Interesting. I've never done fishing, but I love the outside as well, you
mm-hmm.
know, walking in parks or, yeah,
mm-hmm.
hiking if you've got somewhere like that. How about bicycles?
I like that too.
Yeah.
Ooh.
Well, that's something else we could do one day, like take some bicycles, ride out somewhere.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. That would be nice.
Cool.
Oh. Ask her if she has plans this coming week. B, touch her face. You want it louder? She's kind of lame. B is touch her face. C, ask what kind of men she likes. D, run the curb continues. A psychological test. Run the cube routine. It's a psychological test, not C. Ask her what kind of men she likes. Yeah, not C. Ask her plans for the coming week. Touch her face. D, I think D would be a great one because it's like a good, like, thing to do, like, on the other chapters. We did, like, the strawberry test, and, like, we did some other stuff that she liked. I'm eating breakfast. Hey, zombie, welcome back. How you been, zombie? It's been so long. Thanks for joining. Eating breakfast? What time is it for you? It's 11:56 p.m. for me. She has a personality of a paper cup. She does not have a personality of a paper cup. That's so rude. All right. Same. Ask her plans for the coming week.
And are you busy this week? Like, what are your plans for the next few days?
I'm pretty busy. I have my friend is having a party tomorrow, and then this weekend I'm gonna take a train up to Vilnius.
Hmm.
So, pretty busy.
You have free time, though?
Maybe.
Which
maybe
day?
On Sunday.
Sunday, yeah.
Oh.
I might be free on Sunday as well.
Okay.
Oh.
That's exactly right. Now think about this. Have you ever texted a girl saying, hey, can you meet tomorrow? She's like, I'm not in town. And you say, okay. And then text her in a few days. Hey, can you meet tonight? Are you around? Sorry, I've already got plans. Well, to avoid this kind of dumb situation when you end up not seeing her again, why not find out at the time of meeting her what her
exactly.
plans are for the coming week? It's very easy to find out in person. And saves the need for sending loads of dumb text messages that get you rejected. So it's the correct choice.
Job. A paper cup is more useful. Is it bad that I want to be on his bed in a bra too? Ninja. Is it bad that I want to be on his bed with the bra too? That's funny. Suggest a meeting for a drink and take her number. C. Ask her if she has a few spare minutes to invite her to make love in the restroom. Really? C. Suggest to go hiking together sometime and take her number. D, take her number and say you'll be in touch. Did she say she'd like to go hiking, right? I would say C or A. She seems like more of an outdoor person. I would say C. Right, B Max? B. Say, we're not doing B. We're not doing B. She's going to say that she wants to, you want to, you invite her to make love in the restroom. She's not going to do it, guys. She's not going to do it. We're going to pick C. Suggest going hiking together sometime and take her number.
So you like hiking and outdoor stuff, and mm-hmm. the weather's pretty good at the moment. So one day we could
Madsen.
Take a little trip. Or,
I love you guys. Shut up. Asshole.
So why don't you give me your number and we'll arrange something.
Oh. Got the number. Let's go. She's an outdoor person. Yes.
Exactly right. It flows very smoothly to find something.
This girl in the background, right here. I don't know what she's looking at. This one. She's like looking forward.
It's way better than just saying, "Hey, give me your number," or "Hey, let's go for dinner tomorrow."
Mm-hmm. All right. Say goodbye with a warm. Be warm and say it's nice to meet you. Quietly, coldly say goodbye, and you'll be in touch. Give her a long, lingering handshake, a goodbye hug, and then go for a kiss. All right. I would say A. Just be warm, you know, keep her, you know, thinking you're a cool guy, you're nice. I would say A would probably be the best answer. C is no. C is, like, too much. Like, you're holding it for too long. I don't like that. Be cold as fuck. Nah.
Well, look, I should be heading off, but it was great meeting you. Really cool. Mm-hmm. Really, really happy to meet you, and yeah, see you. Bye.
Bye.
Oh.
Oops, you know, you got right to the end, but this is a little bit too much. Being warm at this point, totally unnecessary, and if anything, makes you look like a little bit of a wussy.
Why am I playing this game in IRL? Because I think it's funny. It's more of a just a talkative game. I'm not playing the game as much as talking to the stream. I'm talking to the stream more than
this
I'm,
is a
like...
This playful opener. Again, it can work.
Hugs and kisses? What the fuck? I know, like, what are you supposed to do?